Our story begins in 2007 in a Soho gay bar called the Green Carnation.
It's a night of gay words and music, so the idea is that rather than just being an author reading in a bookshop, I think if you can do that in a setting that's a bit more sort of, you know, social, I think you get more people, and that's proven to be the case.
In 2008, we moved to Trash Palace. And then to Freedom. In 2009, we moved to the South Bank Centre.
She's living with her mum Iris in Great Yarmouth, that beautiful seaside spot. Has anyone been there?
Yeah.
I'm really sorry.
I wish I could lower the tone. But I don't think that's possible.
Polari became more theatrical. Even more diverse. And sometimes, a little risque. ...2019 was our biggest year yet.
That's it. That's all she wrote. No starting with a bang. No announcing herself to the world or to a future reader. No declaration of intent. Instead, I draw a circle and leave it empty. My eye caught by an absence. And it wasn't an aberration. I carried on in that style for years, making countless entries about not buying things. Not going to the disco, not going to school, piano lesson being cancelled, the school coach not arriving. It's a life described by what's missing and what fails to happen.
We toured the country, funded by the Arts Council. We celebrated our 12th birthday with Russell T. Davis and went back to our roots with Polari in Heaven. Heaven was a huge hit, so earlier this year, we came back for more. And to sing us out, here's David McElmont.
Diamonds are forever. I can see every part, nothing hides in the heart to hurt me. Diamonds linger, men are wanna